I was taking a look at the crude oil. What I got coming up in the next class is this. Right now, currently, you can see I'm long right now the S&P 500. I'm sorry, the NASDAQ futures. Why did I go long here? I'm almost a $900 trade, almost a $1,000 trade. Why was this so long here? I scaled 50%, and then I got a runner running. I thought about taking it off at this level up here. I was up almost $1,000, but I like to run in mine to break even plus one. Just a lot of what I like to do, but it had a lot of resistance up there. But why did I go long here? Just off this blank chart, can anybody tell me why I went long? Anybody? Anybody tell me why I went long at that level? Retest, why? Why is that a trade setup? Anybody? Is there any clue that we can see? It's support. What gives me the clue that we're going to go over supply and demand a little bit and teach you guys about supply and demand. Supply and demand. When do you think there's going to be supply or demand in the market? When what happens? When there's a surge in what? Supply and demand lines are automatically created, whether it be institutional traders, retail traders, professional traders. Supply and demand because of speed, right? That is a bull flag, correct. But let's not talk about patterns per se right now. Let's just talk about why that is a buy setup. Because speed came in the market. If speed comes in the market, that means what? What happens when there's speed that comes in the market? What is the market doing? There's what? They're moving price because there's more demand than there's more buyers and sellers, right? So what I'm going to show you coming up in the next conference call and why I like these patterns, I use this pattern a lot with all my charts, with my speed boxes. Why? Because what it tells me is when I see big moves up like this, that tells me there's what? There's more what? If I see big candles like this, what does it educate me with? Now, we did this in the 90s a lot with stocks. Works great with stocks. There's more buyers and sellers, right? That means there's more demand than supply. So what happens is you get a breakout. I'm going to show you a specific pattern I look for. It started back here. This is the reason I went long in the first place. It started right here. I'm going to show you this pattern. It all started right there. So next conference call, I'm gonna show you I draw lines a little bit today, but I'm gonna go real depth. That told me to look for a breakout of this high. So when this high broke, this was a trigger bar right here that told me out of a big demand. I wanna look like Cameron said the first retest. So I put a limit order in just above this breakout. After this closed, put a limit order above the breakout. My stop loss was right below this low. And the speed bars, which I'm going to show you that we use in the room, caught this big move. I did the same thing on the S&P this morning. I'm going to show you where you can actually look for institutional supply and demand on imbalances. You probably heard a lot of people. I talked about it a lot before. The market has buy imbalances and sell imbalances, and I'll show you how to do that. Okay? See, it just got stopped out on a trailing stop loss. There's my trail. So not a bad trade this morning on the 805 and a half, 86. So, I mean, 86 to 8105. Not bad. Not a bad first trade on the NASDAQ, but I'm going to show you this pattern, how it works. So that's something we're going to get into, all right, on the next conference call. All right, so there's a $740 trade on two contracts. That's my first trade of the day on the NASDAQ. All right, so let's take a look at supply-demand lines. Let's look at the crude oil now, and let me show you how I'm going to show you how we can find institutional supply and demand. We already know that we've had long and shorts. I already gave the target here on the S&P. Had a nice trade on that this morning. But let's take a look at how you can project these supply and demand lines. First of all, we got a retest short working right now. What you can do is you can look at these swings and find out when there's major support and major resistance. What happens is that, let's get this off here real quick. That's a breakout coming up. What happens is that when you see when the market's moving down or up, when the market's moving down and up, it's going to give you a supply or demand. When this candle changes color against overall trend, when that changes color and that trend is down, that means I've got what? If I'm in a downtrend, and let me explain this to you, and I'm going to show you how these lines are drawn up. If I'm in a downtrend, you see my moving averages are down. I got red, 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 red bars, and then I got a green bar. What's that green bar represent? You got counter trend traders, right? But it also tells you that we have what now? There's an imbalance right there, right? There's going to be an imbalance right there, so that tells me there's going to be supply there. So what I can do if I'm in a downtrend, I can take the next candle. And you can do some institutional traders do two candles. They take the low, not the low of the wick, but the low of the close. So right here, usually two candles, one, two, and draw your supply line. Now that's my supply line now. Now I know my supply line going forward. And I'm going to show you how I did this retest trade down here also, how it projected all the way back here. So that's my supply line. And you can do, like I said, one or two candles on the imbalance, supply imbalance. So that tells me that I've got resistance going forward. So if it ever breaks and retest, that was a short. Retest, we had another short here from a full retracement. So I'm going to go over that where we can draw supply and demand lines up. Now, how did I get this? How did this low form? How did this exact low form or this retest sell that's going on right now form? What you want to do is you want to go 24 hours back. I'm going to show you how you do this. You go 24 hours back. I'm going to find the recent order imbalance. And it's this pattern right here I'm going to show you. It usually looks like a W bottom or M top. And what you want to do is take the second candle at the close, second candle, and this works on 240-minute charts, 60-minute charts, daily charts. This is how you can find supply demand. There's my target on crude that happened from the short earlier. I'll show you why that's a target. But I'm going to show you in the next class that this W bottom going back 24 hours is support. So that's how this bounced over here at this low. That's why that retest short right to the tick. This is uncanny for having it did on the S&P three times a day too. I can show you pretty much within a couple ticks where the market should turn based upon supply and demand lines drawn on a blank chart. So what you can do is you can do your homework, and I can draw these lines, and I draw these lines in the night before anyway. You can go into yesterday's session and draw these horizontal lines and find out where overall targets will be after you get into my speed bars. So you'll know where support and resistance is. Like I know right now on the crude oil, that's my target, and that's my breakout. So I know if I break this institutional support right here, where did I get it? How did I get that institutional support? Because what I did is, like I said, this pattern looks like a W bottom. There's your W. You go the second bar at the close of the bar, close of the candle, not the high of the wick. Wicks are for amateur traders. That's a close of the candle. There's my close of the candle. It told me right there is support. There's my W bottom. There's my close of the candle, second candle. What does it do? Calls the low, calls the retest short, calls my target. All right, so we're going to be going over this stuff on how to draw supply and support lines. It works really, really well. I'll go over that in the next class that we have. There's a target on crude from earlier. I'm going to show you I can catch these swing. I can show you from yesterday's data where possible turning points are in any market you trade. Doesn't matter. On any time frame. It works on any time frame at all. I just showed you a 1 minute chart on that 700 and some dollar trade I just had on the NASDAQ futures right there. That's a 1 minute chart. That's a 1 minute blank chart on supply demand. That's with no indicators at all. I'm going to show you how to do it. Okay? I use it in conjunction with my speed bars. $740 trade on that last one. All right, so what we want to do is let's take a look at another concept. So that's supply and demand. Let me bring the S&P over so you understand a little bit more. So how did I draw these supply and demand lines? Why did I have a target here? Why was this a scale? All right, so what you can do is you can draw supply demands up. I had a really good demand here at the S&P at this level. And this was actually a long on my speed bars. There's my scale. Why is this my scale? I had an order imbalance here this morning. You see how right there we went red, 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 and then it had one green bar. Once you see a consolidation in candles, that's supply or demand. When bars are turning opposite color, that's usually a supply and demand. You can take the second candle down, and you can put at the close, the close of the second candle, that's your scale. That's your support line too. Why did I have a target up here? Why did it stop up here at price? Because yesterday, I have a top, an institutional top. All you gotta do is go 24 hours back. And I'm gonna go over this in detail. As soon as this breaks this low, right here, I know that that's a level at the close of that candle that should be resistance, right there, second bar down. And I'll show you guys how to do that coming up in the next class. So not only do we have a long on the S&P here on support, my target was all the way up here. So I knew I had a big gap from 655 to 600. I had a 10-point gap on the S&P. I had a 10-point. I like seeing gaps. When I do these lines, I like seeing gaps from yesterday's data to let me know possible winner, winner, chicken dinner right there, right? Also, I know that if I break the S&P down here at 2630, this thing should go southbound on the Greyhound. That's my last institutional support, 2630, as far as 24 hours earlier. So I know if I get through 2630, break retest, this thing should fall really good for me. All right, I try to find gaps in the market, and we're going to go over that in the next conference call. Try to find gaps in the market. So let me take those off. So that's a supply-demand concept. I'm going to show you on a blank chart how to do that. We'll go over that stuff as far as that goes. Let's take a look at crude oil, though. Crude oil. Another concept I want to show you where supply and demand is. All right. Hey, Steve, good morning. Steve, I recorded this because it's very important to find supply and demand lines. And we're going to go over a conference call coming up anyway. Let's go over the next. Yeah, Gerald, hold on one sec, man. Let's go over why this is a sell. Why is this a sell here? Why do you think this is a sell? Why do you think this retest right here is an entry? Anybody know why this is an entry right here? Because the market's in a downtrend. Why? With the full retracement. Two entries. Why? Anybody? I'm going to show you another concept that works great. Why do you think that's an entry? So I'm going to show you how to draw supply demand lines and just show you how to do that. But what do you think that is an entry? Anybody? But let me show you a pattern. There's a certain Renko pattern that's a rejected area. So it broke retest. If you see this, and actually happens all the time on these Renko bars, if I see... And the great ones are when you see, and I'll show you on the S&P it happened this morning. If I see equal tops of four candles, equal tops of four candles, I have a trade because I have some major supply area. There's one, two, three, four. That's four candle top, one candle bottom. It looks like almost like a transformer or let's see, what would it be called? Look at just like a little M right there. It looks like you guys ever play Galaga? Looks like a Galaga ship inverted, right? Looks like a Galaga. So when I every time I see this pattern, I think Galaga. I'm old school. I'm 50 years old, so I grew up playing Galaga, the old school video game, right? So that's it looks like a Galaga ship that's inverted. It's a really nice pattern. So when I see this pattern come up, I know that I got a possible what? I got a possible continuation. So this, we're already in a downtrend for retracement, so that to me is a great short. Stop loss, two ticks above the swing high. Or since I know when this candle changes color, that means that's a supply-demand area. I'll look for the retest, red bar reversal, another entry, and you're off to the races. Now, to show you what it was on the S&P this morning, It looks like this. All right. Remember, four candles. I mean, four candles, minimum three. Right here is three candles. This actually hit almost five times. The equal wicks, one, two, three, four equal wicks, five, six wicks. But I got equal wicks, one, two, three, four, one, two, three. This is a breakout buy. I love this pattern with my Rinko bar. You got to look at this pattern. It called the top yesterday. It called the top yesterday and the bottom four times on the S&P. Now, when we come up, I have my target up here, right? My institutional resistance from yesterday right there. What kind of pattern is that up there? Pac-Man. You like Pac-Man, huh, Adam? What kind of pattern is that up there, guys and gals? What did I just tell you my favorite video game was growing up? That's an M-top or Galaga pattern, right? Looks like a Galaga ship that's inverted. That tells me not only that's my target, but that's my level. Now, I come back over here. I had a sell this morning also. I had a sell. Why is this a sell zone? And this is against trend. Still took it anyway because I love these patterns. Minimum four. Remember four candles that are equal. One, two, three, four sticks that are equal. Two at the high. It came back in my sell zone. I had a full retracement and took it just for a small play. Watch this pattern. Okay, so I have the continuation pattern, a zone pattern. It's got to be four equal wicks on one side of the candle, on one side of the Rinko bar, okay? And then I got the old Galaga pattern, right? Like, we got to find a new name for it, and then Galaga, but it looks just like a Galaga ship, I'm telling you. Is it? Right there is your little, right that low, see, that double top, M top. Hold on, Gerald. One sec, man. So, this is the 5 Simrico. Typically, they happen on the 5 Simrico, yes. You'll see a lot of trades. It's called the, look at yesterday's level. So, that's my two patterns. We're going to go over these two patterns in the conference call. But that is a continuation pattern. Watch. The easiest way to do it for it, Thomas, is watch for four candles, minimum three, that the wicks are pretty much equal on one side. It's minimum three. We just had a high on the S&P because of it. Look at the S&P. Same thing on the larger time frame. See this? One, two, three, four. That is there. That was my target, institutional target. You see that, Thomas? One, two, three, four. That's the turning point on a large time frame. Where the wicks are four on each side, it's got to be just one side. One, two, three, four. But one side's got to be pretty much equal. It just happened on the S&P top. So I can take a blank chart then, and I can pretty much tell, just like on my NASDAQ futures trade, I can pretty much tell when I need to be buying and selling on supply, demand, and institutional support and resistance. And I'll show you how to draw it up. So, like I said, I'll show you these spikes in volume. Spikes in volume create supply and support. Like right now, that spike in volume right there created, that's where I got, my runner got stopped out. That was a line in the sand. I'll show you how to do it. But that big spike and that retest, I'll show you how to take trades like this, all right? But in the room while you're trading, you can just literally look for these patterns, right? The Galaga pattern, there's your break continuation zone based upon the wicks. But let's take it to another low, that's the S&P. And my institutional level that I've marked up earlier caught the high by a couple ticks. We're going to go over in a conference call, go over all that stuff. So let's take a look at the 3SIM. So when you know these levels, I showed you this was a resistance. I drew it before it retested right there. Why was that resistance? That's institutional resistance based upon the previous days institutional support. This is what? See this consolidation? It looks like a W, looks like a J hook or an M hook. That told me that second open is support. So you can project just like this right here. You can project where support and resistance is just by drawing these lines up from the previous day. So we'll go over all that stuff. All right? So that's something to look forward to coming up in our next conference call when I go over the auto. All right, so let's look at the 3-sim. 3-sim Renko. Now, this is very simple. All right? The 3-sim Renko is very simple. What pattern is this? What pattern is that? Anybody? What pattern? We just went over it. That's a Galaga pattern, right? We'll call it the Galaga pattern. All right? So remember, this pattern happens all day long. It doesn't matter what time frame you look at. The larger time frame, the more pronounced the move is going to be. But this is the entry on the retest. This entry based upon our earlier sell signal on the full retracement here at this break. So this broke right here, right? But I want to show you something also on this pattern before Gerald shuts this off. This pattern is the Galaga pattern inside of the wicks. See that? M top. The easiest way to see it, guys, is 4 equal wicks. Doesn't have to be 4 on the other side. Once it breaks retest, had a beautiful sell right here at the high. You're going to see this over and over and over on all time frames. Right? The S&P just now has institutional support at 2669. Why? See that pattern? The little Galaga pattern at the low? 838 on the Renko bar. Now that becomes support. So now we're looking at 2669 will be the level. All right, so that's what we're going to do. So let's go over the algo real quick. Now the algo, what we're going to do is we're going to be going here's this long this morning on the Nasdaq futures. All right. The algo, you guys are going to be getting this. Well, what it will do is it will show you, it tries to get the swings also. So it's trying to get these swings. So this shows all retracements. I like running the algo. Here's a small stop. Here's another continuation down here. I like running it and just watching it for my patterns. My patterns come up with it. It's a really neat way how to do it. But you're going to be getting this. We're going to go over it in the conference call. The next conference call, we're going to go over 3 things. We're going to go over how to draw supply and demand lines, institutional support and resistance. And I'm going to go over this in the room with you tomorrow and Friday also. We're going to go over how to look for one specific Renko bar pattern, the Galaga pattern. And then we're going to go over the algo. Okay, so the next conference call, it's going to be a lot of information. But I'm going to be right to the point. I'm going to show you how to draw your lines. I'm going to show you what to do. And I'm going to show you what patterns to look for. Okay? So I'm going to let Gerald get the algo out to you first. And we are in the final steps right here. We're ready to ship this thing. We just had to update the Renko bar. We're ready to ship it. You can use either one. I get this all the time. Traders ask me, use an 8 or a 10. You can use either one. It really doesn't matter, Larry. Whatever your preference is. Look in your charts. They're relatively the same. Either one you want to use. I just wouldn't use a 20 or a 14 or a 5. Does that make sense, Larry? I don't want to go too extreme. But 10 and 8, they're pretty much the same. All right, so I'm going to tell you one thing, though. Once you understand pattern recognition, you do very, very well. So let me get these lines up.